Hey everyone, this is a follow-up and an alternate solution to the last video I uploaded, which is how to create a meteor shower composite in Photoshop. I wanted to take a moment and show you how to do this in Gimp, which is a completely free software. And in this video, we're only going to stack 7 of the 12 meteors that we stacked in the last video. I picked the 7 brightest ones so that they're a little bit easier to see and easy to work with. This is just to show you the concept. So whether you have 7 meteors or 100 meteors, the idea is the same. So if you don't already have GIMP, you can get it from gimp.org. The current version is version 2.10.36. I already have it downloaded and installed, so I'm gonna run that. So this is the GIMP UI. It's a little bit different. Since this is not a what does GIMP look like video, I'm just gonna skip over what all these things are and start doing the work here. So we're gonna import all of our images as layers, just like we did in Photoshop. So we'll do File, Open as Layers. There's an option here, it's not a script. When this dialog box opens, it opens it to your most recently used directory. These are not the files I wanna work on, so I either have to either click on my drive and go to my directory that I set up for this GIMP video, or I can click on like one of these drives. So I'll go to my EOS Digital. We get this option here, it says type of file name. I click on this. I can go into my Explorer here, copy and paste this. Copy this here. I'm not gonna do that. Press enter, and it now takes me to where I want to be. And these are the 7 files that I wanna open, and I'll click on open. And then you get this option here. If you worked on these images elsewhere, it might have a different RGB color profile, and I'm just gonna keep it as is. I'm gonna say don't ask again, otherwise it'll ask for each of these images, and now it's opening them one by one, and it's pretty quick. And looking at this, this is our first meteor, and I think this is gonna be my reference frame. Remember, we in our previous video, we went through all of them to find a reference frame, but I'm gonna do that anyway. So I'm gonna start clicking these off and taking a look at what the different meteors look like. So yeah, I think this is the first one is gonna be my reference frame. So I'm gonna click and drag this all the way down so that it's at the bottom layer. Now I'm gonna click on the next layer up, and we're gonna create a mask here just like we did in the previous one. But first I'll enable this so that we can see the meteor. The two ways you can create a mask is if you go to layer, mask, and then add layer mask, or there's an option at the bottom right hand here that says add a mask that allows non-destructive editing of transparency. So we'll click on this. And unlike Photoshop, GIMP asks you what kind of mask you want from this dialog box without having to do an invert. So I want a black one, so full transparency. And I'll click on add. And now we have a black mask here. Some of the shortcuts are different. If, for example, you accidentally set a white mask, you can go to colors and you do invert, and it'll invert it. So then it becomes a show mask. But we're gonna turn it back into a hide mask, this and invert. Colors and invert. I don't know if there's a shortcut to do that. If you know it, let me know. I have not looked it up. So, okay, so we have this. So another shortcut to turn this off is you can do control click, or you can right click, and then you can click on disable layer mask. It does the exact same thing, to turns, puts a red border around it instead of a red X. So control click enables and disables it. So you wanna make sure it is disabled. Now we're going to zoom into the meteor here, and we're going to select our brush tool, which is F, not B. We have our brush options here, so you can see that I already kind of worked on it. So the hardness I set to about 50%, and the size 4 pixels. I think if I zoom in a little bit more, it's good. I can probably take it down to 3 pixels. All right, 3 pixels. 3 pixels may be too much. All right, 4 pixels, and zoom out a little bit. And now I'm gonna do the exact same thing as I did in Photoshop. So I'm gonna click here, and I'm gonna take my mouse all the way to the end here, hold shift. And one thing I like about GIMP is that it shows you a line of where your mouse, where the paint job will be, unlike Photoshop where you're kind of guessing. And this helps you make sure that it's straight and you're getting the meteor in a more even fashion. So I click on this. So it created a white brush stroke. To see it, that is, you do Alt and then you click on this, and you can see the brush stroke. You do Alt click again, and we see the meteor again, but the mask is still turned off. So now we do Control click. Now we're back in. Now I'm going to zoom out, and now we see both of those meteors in one frame. Alright, so I'm going to do one more really quickly. We'll do this one. This is pretty bright, so I'm going to move this down. And then I'll zoom through the rest of them. So, when I click on this, layer mask, a black mask, so that adds. And then I'll turn this off. So I'll zoom in. And one thing I noticed while practicing is that a harder brush, so if I click on this, 75 hardness, does better for the colors here. So switch this back to 4 pixels. And you'll see, so I'll do click all the way here, click, and then if I turn this off, the colors kind of remain. And I noticed that if you click on the 50%, as I mentioned before, like between 50 and 60% was where I landed for good transparency, for good masking. This in GIMP, 75% seems to be really good. So there we go. Now we can turn that off, zoom out, doesn't center automatically. So there we go. All right, so now I'm gonna zoom through the rest of them. Alrighty, went through the rest of them pretty quickly, and now this is what my composite looks like with my 7 meteors. It does look like a lot of them are over here. It's because a lot of these ones here were dimmer. As you can see, there's the light pollution from Boston over here, so a lot of the light got absorbed by those lights. But anyway, so this is what it looks like. And this is with GIMP, completely free. Download it, give it a shot. Pretty easy to do once you get the hang of it. If you have any questions about anything I covered in this video or my previous video, let me know in the comments below. If you want me to cover something that I haven't covered, also let me know. Hope to see you in my next astronomy adventure. Clear skies.